shit was good. What then? That's the only natural way to do it. Get your own fruit, put it in a blender.
Man, please. That ain't nothing but some of that orange citrus punch from Aldi's.
I don't shop like you, Shorty.
No, sir.
I go the natural route.
All right, salute. Welcome back to another show of the Power Hour. I got my man Milk on the General. I got my man DFing guy, aka Kushin Eugene, in the building. Mr. J, go wanna know what they found. They found better weed smoke than you smoke, Mr. J. I heard it through the grapevine. Diddy smoking better than you. Clark on the check-in. Good morning. Blue Label has an invitation to today's show. Vic Vega has an invitation to today's show because they're home. Melquan, how do you feel about Blue Label and Vic Vega joining the show?
We need them both in here.
Ain't no room for either one of you.
Brooks will also be joining the show. We got a lot to talk about.
I'm tired of her, too.
Are you crazy? Do you know how long it's been since we had a female back-to-back-to-back female? 3 days?
I'm sick of her.
Yeah. 3 days? Three days? In a row we had a female voice. Are you crazy? I'm in podcasting heaven right now.
Yo, I got a female that wants to get into.
So why don't you put her down, man?
Because I'm talking about it to you now.
Oh, okay.
Speaking of females. I got a chick that she turns up. She turns up here, too.
Okay. Is she at home with no what do we call dreams or aspirations? She got free time. She's home.
Yeah.
We don't need boss ladies. This whole goddamn platform is full of boss ladies. I need some worker bees.
She got some time on her hands in the mornings.
Now, does she like to smoke, Melquan?
Yes, she does.
Is she articulate, Melquan?
Yes.
And does she have a sense of humor, Melquan?
Yes, she does.
We're talking about Rich.
Yes, she does. And she's a white female.
Send it, Mr. J. Send it to the email, ruckusradio87@gmail.com, mobstories87@gmail.com. You pick or choose. Fruities and Delato plus some pine salt. God damn, Mr. J smoking good this morning. Let me give you a round of applause.
That's not, he ain't smoking that shit.
Well, you know. He says, you know my reputation. David from across the pond. Good morning, Greg. Good morning, D Hollow. We're still on for the 13th and 14th. I will keep you in the loop. And
D Hollow showing up. D Hollow be there. I told you, D, he'd be there without a doubt. But Saturday's, I'm only doing that
Saturday. I know you're rocking Saturday. I know. I know. I am going to be. I'm going to be around Sunday to host when you leave.
Yeah, I'm
gonna I'll be around Sunday. I took the 2 days off because Jamari is coming through. D Hollow will be there, so I took Saturday, Sunday off. Saturday, I'll be hosting. Me and Mel Kwan will be hosting. Then Saturday night, I'm going to set it up for Nino Brown and Mel Kwan, the Real Deal Alcoholics. I got a couple of bottles for them after everybody finished with the night and chilling. Then the drinkers will get to drinking. You know what I mean? Brooke's in the building. She's probably checking in from a house with no electricity because sometimes that's how it is. You lose your electricity in the building. And before we start the show, I just want to show you a video of Brooks was walking down in the street, okay?
Coming up
some migrant tried to drive by on a scooter and rob Brooks. And we have video footage. Somebody tried to scooter rob Brooks. We have video. We have video footage of how my friend Brooks. The guy's lucky she didn't have her Spike Timberlands on because she was matching her outfit with her shoes. You understand?
This is real shit.
So for anybody that wants to test Brooks in the street, you have video footage. Video footage of how Brooks gets down for the crown. Okay.
The loot to that female.
Yeah.
Right? Absolutely. That's one thing. I told shit about the blocks, but I dare you to mess
with the sister. What the fuck you want me to do?
I dare you to mess with a sister. She gonna kick your ass, Jack.
Now, obviously, we know that.
Brooks, what are you doing by the projects anyway? What, you was busting a sale over there?
Look, I can't stand you, dude. I can't stand you.
Brooks, I cannot stand you. Ask that question. Like, what is Brooks doing in the projects?
Listen, who minds your business what Books got to do in the project?
My name is Books, sir, not Books. Thank you. Books is from Daz Effect, sir.
Did I say Books? I like to read Books. Anyway,
or Big Daddy Kane, though.
Now, we all know that wasn't Brooks. I was just joking around. We know that wasn't Brooks. But I'm going to say whoever that was kind of a little hired up. I mean, she's kind of a big woman, a big lady right there. Okay,
so I don't know how you do it.
She was, I don't know. She's
a black woman, go rogue.
Yeah, you know how these, how you doing? They may not be women, but they identify themselves as a woman. And Black Hat Music are recovering from his heart surgery. Salute to you, sir.
Salute to you, man. Salute.
We got some great fucking music, 80s representing. Mel Kwan is the only one that didn't send in selection today. So, Mel Kwan, you will be the one that rates the choices. Plus, we have a special choice from Brooks. Brooks, we have the Baltimore Bridge Collapse. We have P. Diddy.
Yes.
We have a new NYPD cop being murdered. We have somebody that got pushed off the train by a madman who waited for the train to approach. He timed it, he calculated it, and with all his strength, pushed this person in front of a train and killed this person. We have video of that. So, Brooks, you let me know how we're going to start. Go ahead.
I also have a special report that Black people need to pay attention to.
Okay, let's do the report after you leave. So after you leave the show, we'll do the report at 10:40. I'm only joking.
You know what? I'm gonna get it out the way. I'm gonna get it out the way because it's gonna be
Let's get Mel Kwan, Black Entertainment Report, really quick.
Ahead, I see the Fu Young Young messing up. Let Mel Kwan go. I'm just gonna mute and I'm just gonna relocate real quick. I'm not logging off.
Okay, whose house are you gonna run into now? The next door neighbor across the street? Whose house you're running into?
The other neighbor.
Brooks, if you don't know, Brooks is a master jewel thief. She knows how to pick locks. So Brooks can break into anybody's house and use their
locks, matching pills.
Yeah, the train. That's right. It happened at 125th Street train station, and the victim's name has not been released yet. But I got a video of the perpetrator. Blue Label Media in the building. Let me give him a little spotlight right now. A solo layout, real quick. Boom. Don't like the solo layout. Boom. Okay,
nah, he don't like that.
Solo layout.
No. He don't like that. You calling your job and telling them that you took off today to be on the show. I'm
Blue Label, good to see you. You know, Blue Label sends in all the killer music that we listen to most of the time. We appreciate it.
No, it's not always.
Yeah, you have a problem with everything I say about Blue Label or Vic Vega. Blue Label is also going to try to make it for Saturday. He said he's going to try to make it, not to count him out. So we will not count him out.
So I got three fights. Oh, that's sad.
Mel Kwan, please.
I'm knocking.
Okay, thank you, Vic Vega. Okay, they're already. Vic Vega is already working on a Fragile Man comic book. He's talking about beating up three people.
Little Diesel Midget.
Little Diesel Midget. Midgets are strong. Don't sleep on Diesel Midgets.
I ain't worrying about the Haiti kid.
You know the strength. Okay, remember the Haiti kid? The Haiti kid didn't play coming off the top rope.
Well, I'm going to step on his little neck. Can't wait.
That Jew Santana weed.
Yeah. Uh huh.
All right.
So, anyway, now, as we wait for Brooks to come back, we got a bunch of shit to talk about, right?
Quick report.
Yeah, go ahead.
Let's get this out the way. This is very, very shocking. Okay. I'm subscribed to these brothers called Black Culture, where they talk about a lot of Black culture and a lot of events from due to the black experience.
Yeah, now, long story short, channels on this channel.
Long story short, don't cut me off, sir. Long story short, there was a big discovery that happened, and big up to the Russians. All right.
You remember Nikolai?
Anybody the flag in the world, because you know the perception of Jesus. I don't want to do religion, but you know the perception of Jesus, how the Europeans paint him to be a white man with blonde hair. Every church in the world has the white Jesus on the wrong. False prophecy, like I learned. And this is why. Because Russia has brought out the Russian president. He created a brand new museum that has artifacts and history of the original paintings and pictures that shows the proof that Jesus was black and his disciples was black. Mama was black.
Somebody took pictures because
they got a lot of artifacts.
They said they went to a vote.
Right, they got a lot of paintings, a lot of shit. So it went when it came down to it, Russians preserved it through, which is crazy. Thank you. The Russians threw it because it's just go on, man. The Russians preserved it.
What's wrong, Mel Kwan?
My son trying to talk to me. I sent him to the store.
I'm like, just go on, man.
I'm like, just go on, man. But long story short, this is really serious. Like, the Russians have preserved this because back in the early times when they had the Mongolian War, when the Russians was invading North Africa at the time, they they took all the paintings and the artifacts and all this stuff and preserved it and hid it from the communist parties and everybody else who tried to steal all this stuff, all of these facts. And the Russians now were putting it out there. So they were showing it. And you see how Jesus was black. His disciples was black. They put everything. Yeah, and that should show you people who sit there and whatever religion, I don't knock nobody religion. You know what I'm saying? The seven just rock.
That okay, let me ask you a question. Let's say that
I didn't finish, sir.
Okay, before I try to get some last knowledge.
Point, and then hurry up. Sir. No, I'm not hurrying, sir.
I'm going to cut you off with a song in 2 minutes, man.
So yeah, before I try to get some motherfucking knowledge, man.
The
question I ask, because it ain't. Shut up. All right, let me finish. Shit.
Fragment. Fragment foot, bitch. Because
around the
it
world,
is my turn. Your whole
life, you've been misguided, and thanks to the seven who make you search that. I found out that, and I have the facts now and the proof. So stop promoting this white Jesus shit because it's not real. He was
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Now with your questions. Okay. Now you can really interrupt. Eugene, now Eugene, you can go ahead
Eugene,
with your
Eugene, Eugene. I want to get. No. I want to let everybody get a chance to talk. I am going to talk the least today. Go ahead, Eugene.
I just want to say this, Mel. You know what you just stated, been proved, right? When they describe him in the Bible as being black with hair like wool.
Right.
Yeah.
And copper skin tone.
So yeah, but
we found that out from Michael Evans, brother. You're a little late.
No, you're late.
I think he just
the knowledge I just dropped. You didn't catch the jewel, but
Blue Label. What are you saying?
I think he just astonished that they actually coming out with information
right,
now.
Right. So here's
we are
my
new,
question.
You know.
What? Here's my question. Let's say they prove Jesus is black or Jesus was black. How does that change the world? Is anything going to change? Are these just fucking imagery. Idiots that are doing imagery. Fucking TikTok dances? Are TikTok dances all fucking day? These adults. Is everything? Is anything going to change if Jesus was black?
No,
they'll start selling T-shirts. They'll capitalize on it.
That just
well, you get to tease all these preachers out here.
While y'all sitting in these churches, which I don't know, and you being false prophesized, the truth is out there. And the people who got the proof, the real actual proof besides Africa, is the Russians. So big up to them.
I'm about to get crazy. So
yeah, get crazy.
When we die, supposedly our skin go back to dust, right?
Yes, we do. We do.
So what do it matter what color?
Thank you.
I don't think you blacken in heaven or what not right. existent.
We go.
I just think it's a wake up call for all blacks to wake up. All right.
That day was somebody. That day was somebody.
World become a better place. Does the world become a better
it
place?
It needs to be.
If
it
Jesus
needs
was,
to be.
If everybody agreed that Jesus was black, does the world does black on black crime decrease? Will it disappear?
It's gonna stop. It's gonna stop. It's gonna magically stop.
Hey, it's gonna magically stop. Is the murders gonna magically stop?
It should. Yeah.
It should, Melquan. But
hey, Rich, let me ask
but
you this.
This is the year of the truth.
Have any of y'all seen that documentary where they expose the queen and all them, like all that jewelry that they was wearing back in the day?
They robbed from Africa.
That's all the stuff that they stole from Africa.
They got a diamond from India that India's like, yo, give us that fucking diamond back, you fucking thieves.
Right.
They got one of the largest diamonds in their collection. They took it from India.
Yeah. So
and they did a whole fucking series on PBS called The Jewel of India. It's how the prince came in and robbed them.
If they had that, imagine how much they have hidden and how much they destroyed. So you wouldn't know.
Yeah.
The truth can never really fully come out because it's too much that's been destroyed.
Get out the dog.
That's why I say subscribe to the seven. You learn the truth.
All right, Brooks is having problems stealing Wi-Fi. We understand that. It's not easy. So we know that Diddy got raided. We know that there were multiple raids on the East Coast and West Coast. They went into his house. Ironically, it was on the 27th anniversary of Biggie Smalls' life after death. Which Cameron and Mace were talking about. They were laughing it up without
anniversary, sir.
That's what I just said.
And Mason was 21 years. I mean, Cam, 20 years. anniversary.
Right, the Jewels, the Dipset album, correct. Right.
No, do this correct. Seem like a little bit like it's like too much though?
What?
No, like everything. Like, I mean, we all know the man crazy or whatever, but don't just feel like it's like overkill a little bit.
Overkill in the sense of what? Going after the man, his name in the media. I mean, I don't. I mean, as far as the media is concerned, they just busted a nut. This is fucking front page shit.
He deserves everything he's getting.
Honestly, what I think it is after all them stories about Harvey Weinstein and the parties they was having back in the day with all the celebrities and shit like that.
Yeah.
The government is determined not to let that shit happen again. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and somebody went after him.
Yeah, yeah. And then here go the crazy part. Shout out to 50 Cent for dry snitching, talking about Jay-Z gonna be next.
Oh, ooh. Shit.
50 Cent.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Okay. That's dry snitching.
Let's get into this video. Brooke sent me a video this morning of what Diddy's house looked after they tore it up. All right? So let's do that real quick.
Damn.
All right, I'm back.
They're taking pictures of the man's shit and everything, man. What the fuck?
Yeah, the kids' rooms.
He deserved it.
They pulled out hard drive mainframes. They popped all of the safes in the buildings.
They're all gonna laugh at you.
Look, why you love it. Look at your face.
I love
you
it. Like, yeah.
I know he's so stupid.
I love it.
One of the things I heard that they said somebody, one of the people that got a claim against him, said that how he had cameras in areas it wasn't supposed to be. He was watching people. So they was taking anything electronic.
Fucking voyeur. He's a voyeur.
Yeah, they was taking anything out of there that was electronic.
Raymond Reddington and shit.
Damn, he do got about 600.
Reddington, that's funny. Not too many people caught the blacklist comment, but I did, Blue
Label. They slept for that rut.
They slept. They didn't say blacklist. So, I love that show, by the way.
Let me ask you a question, Rich.
Yeah.
You in NY, do Diddy Bop take on a whole new meaning now?
Well, I'm going to tell you something right now. No Diddy. No Diddy.
Ooh, I hope they don't got nothing, man. I'm gonna say that much. I just hope
Let me give Blue Label a round of fucking applause for fucking being Team Diddy. You son of a guy.
Hold on. Hey Blue, I'm Team Diddy too.
We all know he a motherfucker, but I mean I just hope all this crazy shit.
What rhymes with bisexual predator? I don't know, but I'm just gonna put that out there.
I hope they don't find anything anyway, but 50 Cent and others did have a great point. You don't get this far to raid these houses if you don't have something and you're looking for something.
Come up with nothing.
Salute to TMZ Video for always having the good videos.
And then you have to understand this too. Like the crazy part about that is with them going into his house, they had to have a warrant. To go have a warrant, you had to go into a judge and show that you had so much evidence that proved there to be more. So the fact that a judge signed for Homeland Security, which even got the Fed shaking, is some shit right there. You know what I'm saying? Like
Multiple raids on two coasts. That's two judges.
This is what I see.
That's not one judge, right? Yes. It's two judges.
This is what I'm saying. Look, Jerry, when the Feds raided his house, nothing positive came from that. You understand? When they raided R. Kelly shit, nothing positive came from that. So once the Feds move in, it's done. It's a wrap.
They got him. You know what? I believe that he thought that the kids couldn't be arrested or the kids couldn't be charged with anything. So that's okay, y'all stay here. I'm going to get the jet gassed up and I'm going to head over to the islands where I can't be extradited. So
he can do.
Yeah. En route to that,
Okay, so here's what I heard. I heard that he got stopped by the feds at the Miami airport.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But he was still able to take off. There was an arrest at the Miami airport. They arrested this white boy that rolled with Diddy. And they are saying, this is the guy that handles his drugs and guns. Let's watch this.
Yep. He's going down because of this dude.
Laquan, we got tape of everything today.
But that's what I'm saying. Like,
the mule.
Brendan Paul. Hello, Brendan.
Thing is, they wasn't at the same airport, though, Rich.
Okay, they weren't at the same airport? No. Okay.
Bump took off from a private airport. This dude got caught at Opa Locka Airport.
Yes.
Cousine Eugene, sprinkling facts.
He's going to go down, though. Wealth He's not going to take the fall for Puffy. He's a white dude. He's not going to take the fall for Puffy. That's going to be Puffy's kryptonite.
Hold on, Eugene. We gotta dig deep into this kid's family. Let's see what his family life is. You know what I'm saying?
But who are you talking about?
He will take the fall if his family is poor. They're from middle America,
Brendan
Kentucky.
Paul?
Yeah.
I don't think it's
this guy used to be a college basketball player. He doesn't have really
well,
much
time. Well, I heard matter. That. I heard
yeah,
that.
He doesn't have much time under his belt, but still, they credit him for that.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing.
Yeah, gummies.
They're going to offer him such less time that he's going to turn off up. He's going to. Whether his family is rich or not, the fact that he can walk away from this and he can come up because he going to sell books, movie deals, and everything else off of it.
He looks like he's snitching.
Wait. You think he's going to snitch over a bag of coke and a pack of gummies?
Yep.
This guy was bailed out 2 hours later.
He's not going to snitch.
He's going to do the time. He'll get a lawyer and go to a program. Are you crazy?
Yep. Yeah. Exactly. Listen. Especially
we're talking about cocaine in Miami.
Yeah.
Was it in Miami?
That's when they start talking the numbers and scaring us.
I don't even think it's a felony. No, it is a felony. But he's going to get a lawyer. Puffy's going to get him out. The gummies will be thrown in court. The gummies is laughable. One name, Rich.
Shine. You see what he did, how he left Shine in the lurch? Yeah. Puffy has a history. This white dude is telling. Call him Gunner.
Puffy.
No,
you're saying Puffy. So you're. Thank you, Eugene. That's something you don't ever hear about.
Right?
So wait.
Can I? 2738 and one such and such.
That nigga snitching. His first chance.
Absolutely not. No, hold on. And I'm going to tell you why he's not snitching. Because Puffy and or his people will hand over the Paul family a substantial amount of money for Mr. Paul to his mouth
and
be quiet. He will do whatever minimal time he has to do, and he will get out and get paid. Yes, Shine took the fall. Shine did 10 years, but look at Shine now. Shine is shining.
Puff did nothing for Shine, though. Shine is outside of America now.
He's some big political guy or whatever now.
Shine is shining. He's like Jewish. He's the president of the House of Representatives. You know who really won out of this whole situation? Because you could tell the way when he was laughing about it in the Mace. Mace was all smiles yesterday. When they were doing the show with Cameron, you know what he called it? Reparations.
He's like, reparations.
They was waiting on this day.
Mace's statements is going to get him called to the stand.
Okay, he's so being already, that we're already, okay.
He stated he knows too much. So he's
the fact that
to
the fact
stand.
That he was involved with drugs just boggles me. Puff and
gun.
Yeah, you should have people. You should have learned. You should have been away from that.
One at a time, sir.
Mr. Paul is out of reach from Puffy. The fact that the feds got their hands on him, he's out of reach. He's going to be Puffy's nail. The feds got him now. He's out of reach. After they threatened his 8-year-old daughter, feds took him and his family. They out of reach now. So it's no way Puffy can get him enough money. You don't have enough money. Not to get him out of the feds.
Shorty gonna snitch. And it's more nails than Puff's coffin right now.
I tell you what, it's very, very entertaining. And I ain't saying it like I'm happy, but it's entertaining.
Say it. You're happy. You are very entertained.
I am happy. But no, it's entertaining to watch this shit unfold in real life, man. Like,
they are going to R. Kelly this man. They're going to R. Kelly him, man. This guy eventually is not going to see the daylight. I'm telling you.
When you're involved with sex trafficking, when you're violating
sex trafficking,
young,
sir.
That's what I said. Okay. That's what I said, sir. Okay. And when you're involved with messing with minors, then
it's almost like somebody out to get him, like the Tupac shit. Good. This shit, that shit. Yes. What's gonna work? Let's throw shit at the wall, see what sticks.
See what sticks. Exactly, I said that too.
Honestly, like I said earlier, number one, I think it is what it is. Is a lot of these people in the industry that think they're above the law, they're going after them now. This is not the 70s and the 80s when you can get away with that shit. That's number one. Number two, in this day and age, this is the social media. Come up, let me be something. It's more people who got something to gain from me than Puffy got to lose.
I am very happy today.
People can come out and tell their story after they make it and come up and get a bag. What loyalty do I have to Puffy? This is about me now. You know what I'm saying? So it's big money in telling their story on Puff. So they going, man, listen. Mm-hmm.
All right. Listen, I want everybody to hold their thoughts. I have a public service announcement from Puffy himself.
Now it's on the hot track, melt like it's hot wax. Put it out, all the stores, bet you can stop that. Leave a nigga with a hot hat, frontin' like Bad Boy ain't got tracks. Nigga, stop that. There's no guy slicker than this young fly nigga. Nickel nine liquor, floss you die quicker. This bedtime, out of town pie flipper. Turn Chris Dallas to a crooked eye sipper. Everybody wanna be fast, see the cash. Fuck around they weak staff, get a heat rash. Anything a Bad Boy way, we smash. 100 G stash, push a bulletproof E flash. I'm through with being a player and a baller. Just want me one bad bitch so I can spoil him. Mates wanna be the one to respect. Over when you backtrack, you shot your jokes over still be next. Never seen, so you suck my juice. Clutch my ooze. Anything I touch, I bruise. Puff make his own law, nigga, fuck your rules.
That's right. Fuck your rules.
Puff make his own laws. Fuck the rules. Listen.
Good fellas, you know you can't touch us, dude. Don't push us, cause we're close to the edge. We're trying not to lose our heads. Broken glass everywhere. If it ain't about no money, Puff, I just don't care. That's I'm right. That good fella, fly guy, sometime wise guy. Spend time at H-A-W-A-I-I.
Mace, can you please stop smoking la-la?
Puff, why try? I'm a thug, I'm a die. I be out in Jersey, puffin' Hershey. Brothers ain't worthy to rock my derby. So I'm never drug free when I'm in the club, G. Though I know the thug be wanting to slug me. Could it be I move as smooth as Bugsy? Yeah. Or be at the bar with two and Bugsy? Yo, I think it must be the girls wanna lust me. Or is it simply the girls just love me? Brothers wanna rock my rolls, rock my clothes, rock my ice. Pull out blocks, stop my life. I'm like, damn, how these niggas got that trust? Used to be my man, how you gon' plot on my wife? Do you think he snake me cause he hate me? Or he got a PhD, player hating degree?
Can't nobody take my pride. Can't nobody hold me down. Oh no, I got to keep on moving.
Quick, you a big cat. Where your chicks at? Where your whips at? Wherever you get stacks, I'ma fix that. Everything that's big dreams, I did that. Don't knock me cause you're boring. I'm repping self soaring, straight touring. Simply a lot of men be wanting to hand me cause their words just don't offend me. We spend cheese in the West Indies, then come home to plenty cream Bentleys. You name it, I could claim it. Young, black, and famous, with money hanging out the anus. And when you need a hit, who you going to get? Better against us?
Nah, it's no bet.
We make hits that'll rearrange your whole set. Right. And got a Benz that I ain't even drove yet.
Don't push us, cause we're close to the edge. We're trying not to lose our heads.
Just to feel that you time to make me wonder why you want it. take us under?
Why you wanna take us under?
I get the feeling sometimes that make me wonder why you wanna take us under.
Why you wanna take us under?
Can't nobody take my pride. Can't nobody hold me down. Oh no, I got to
make some motherfucking hits. Gotta get them at.
Can't nobody take my pride. Can't nobody hold me down. Oh no, I got to keep on moving. Can't nobody take.
Classic Puff Daddy and the Family.
That classic. Is a classic song. I cannot classic. Front. There was a time that I would drive around in the Expedition blasting
Expedition
this song.
Expedition.
Whoever thought Puff would get canceled, man.
No, I had an Expedition back in the late 90s. Thank
you. See, here's the thing, though. You know, he should be thinking they lucky stars. I think he honestly
I gotta show you pictures, you no car having fragile man.
Yeah, nigga, you ain't have no fucking.
Hold on.
You don't even have a car now. That's your mom's car.
Clark is the same guy that said that Tyson was getting paid $75 million. I still can't find a fucking article that says Mike Tyson's getting paid $75 million.
You keep claiming that you got a whip. You don't got no car, son.
Why are you yelling, Melquan?
To no one, sir.
I'm angry.
Angry
man.
He's using his bus voice.
Driving around with the Black Expedition. While you and Mac J were taking bus and waiting at the bus stop, I was the guy in the Black Expedition driving by. Hold that, Dark Greasius.
You have no expedition, sir.
Salute to Mac J. All right, so drug mule arrested. I say he doesn't snitch at all.
I said he don't snitch either.
Let's continue with the Puffy story. You know how Brooks is a fan of the royal family.
Yeah, what's up with that Prince Harry shit?
When Brooks says prayers at night, she includes the royal family with her prayers to protect the royal family. Here's another story. Prince Harry named in the Diddy sex trafficking suit.
I was hurt.
I picture you almost fainting in the kitchen.
Yeah, I was hurt.
And John helping you.
Yeah, they're trying to get this nigga out of here, man. They got him.
Dang.
They call him princes and shit.
Milquan, you got the Platinum Metro Edition, son.
Somebody use a picture or something to get high profile people to a party.
Are you asleep, Melquan?
No, Melquan is high. He's high.
I was reading. Wow, I can't believe that, man. Melquan, I mean, well, I can believe
know,
it. All the people
I
in power.
We know you can't read.
All the people in power.
Yeah.
Like, they're being
their hands are
so
dirty,
what
right?
Harry have to do with it. Harry's just an innocent bystander.
Let's be objective here, Brooks.
One at a time. The higher ups are being exposed like no other, and everybody is either sex trafficking or something to do with minors. And I love it. I love them. I want all of y'all to go to jail. All of you.
Hold on, Melquan. I'm with you.
I got no remorse.
Melquan's a father. We got to protect the children from these predators, Melquan.
Listen, people like us, we got to work. We gotta save all our bread, all our lives. It still ain't enough. We ain't got enough. We ain't got a percentage of what we really want. These guys, these people are on the upper tier. They spoil rich and all, they running around sex
and abuse it.
Go to jail. Let's one more time applaud, man. Please, for listen, everybody.
He said one more time applaud, man.
Hold on, really quick,
Mr. J just wants to let everybody know that he has weed that Melquan will never have.
You don't have no weed like that.
Let me tell you the name of this strain. GMO Z cake. No, Mr. J ain't playing. I know that.
You don't have Mr. J crib. You don't hang with him.
But he sends me pictures. He sends me pictures.
Hey, Mr. J.
I can send you pictures too. It's online.
Hey, Mr. J. You said that. He said that's GMO. Is that garlic, mushrooms, and onions GMO? That's what I wanted to ask him. And y'all know who should be thinking they lucky stars, and they still might go after him. He ain't that old yet. Russell Simmons.
Oh yeah, no, Russell Simmons ain't never come back. No, did
he? He ain't coming back.
Russell was giving people money and signing lifetime NDAs. Like, you don't dare talk about this shit.
Yeah.
Like, Russell was smart. He protected himself.
Yes, he did.
Rest of these cats, they going after them now because
I heard Star said he got served, the right process server in Bali.
In Bali, word.
Hey, Eugene,
but can they extradite him to come back? Or
oh,
not?
Russell Simmons, that's right. He did get served.
Can they
can they
make him come back? Or no?
Oh, but they can make him come back.
Mm-mm.
I don't think they can make
it. Dubai doesn't have an extradition treaty with the U.S. You know, they on good terms, but they ain't on terms like that.
Hey, there will be no peace unless there's Greece. Oh, said by the great Mac J. Adams. Yo. Thank you very much. And since Mel Kwan pointed that out,
a nickel bag is sold in the park.
I want in.
I pressed the wrong button. But still, that's always a classic soundbite.
But did you guys see all the reels and the memes about Puffy and the kids and everything?
The Diddler.
Anyways, no time.
I thought I was bad. Anyways, no time.
You know, I wish Nino Brown was here. Because Nino Brown is a police officer in L.A., and he was very upset about the police officer that was shot and killed merely for asking a criminal, lifelong criminal, violent offender who literally had a 4-inch knife stuck up his rectum because he was ready to go to jail, so he was already prepared. This is the man's mentality. He had a 4-inch shiv, Mel Kwan, as they call it, boofed it, as they call it, and they found it when they did their search. This man killed an officer who left behind, a wife and two children, okay? Here it is. Mel Kwan, you see our little logo up there in the corner? You see, you know, Shay set it up at the corner right there.
I see it now. Look at your man.
Again.
Oh, this is money from Long Island.
Yes, but you're never on top of your Long Island stories. I gotta do the work for you.
A man from Long Island.
It is the good guys against the bad guys.
Look at this joke.
And these
of a
bad
mayor.
Guys are violent. They carry guns.
Your black skin.
And the symbol of our public safety, which is that police uniform, they have a total disregard for. And this incident took place in a neighborhood. I learned just a few moments ago it was right outside of Councilwoman Savina Brooks Power's office. And just watching people walk down the block as these dangerous individual inflicted a level of violence that took the life of a police officer, of a husband, of a son. And we could see it as the role that police officers play every day as they move towards violence. But the reality is, this is a loved one that we lost, a young man. My heart goes out to Jonathan's family, Stephanie, and all that are in the room, giving them the support.
that's a sad, sad fucking story. And yeah, the conversation I want to have with Nino, I'm still going to have it with you guys, is I don't think police officers need to fucking have to get out of their car and ask somebody to move from a fucking bus stop. Like, do you understand what I'm saying? Just let him park there. Let the bus who has a camera take a picture of the license and you ticket the guy. Like, I mean, all in all, like you understand what I'm saying? Like, it's such a stupid reason to get killed.
But listen to his job. Listen to Rich, though.
Right. That shouldn't be part of a police officer's job requirement then, dude.
It is. That's what they do.
Hold on, Rich, though. But now, think about it. Even though she ain't, imagine this Mama Ruckus that got to get off that bus now. He got to park in the middle of the street, and she got to walk from the street to the curb.
Well, I hear what you're saying. Mama Ruckus is not allowed to take public transportation.
That's right.
He's not allowed.
This is what I'm saying. Like, yeah, they were sitting in the bus stop. That's just
cool. Yeah, you can't blame him from doing his job. He's just like, get the fuck out the way.
But you know what? Police officers must fucking hate this shit.
Yeah.
A bulletproof vest. I got a bulletproof vest. I got a fucking gun, and I got multiple rounds. And here I am, fucking asking this guy to move from a fucking bus stop. What's the fucking crime? Let him get a fucking ticket from the camera on the fucking bus and keep it fucking moving. You would have saved your fucking life.
The crazy part is most people on the bus show up for a bus stop ticket.
He's doing his job. That's you can't park at the bus stop. Get the fuck out the way.
As a cop, I would have been like, "Fuck him, let him park there."
Here's the thing. On the flip side of it, that's in his mind, that was easy policing because I'm doing, you know, there doesn't seem like there's a major, you know, emergency or anything.
Let
like that.
Let the traffic police go and tell them to move. Let the traffic police go and tell them to move.
I mean,
that's what traffic
York
police
rich.
Are there for. You have traffic police and then you have fucking NYPD police.
But you don't
let
know
the
what
traffic police go there and fucking tell them to fucking move. That's your job.
But if
that's
they're not there, then you're supposed to take that. You're supposed to take the lead on that.
I guess so. That's a fucking sucky way to fucking die, dude.
It is.
Over a fucking bus stop.
Well, hold on. Where did you get the shiv in the butt from? Like, where?
In today's newspaper, they said when they did a body search of him, he had a 4-inch shiv in his ass because he thought he was going to jail that day. He was prepared to go to jail that day. That was
so he was just walking around with that all day. Yeah.
Crazy.
Hey, Keenan, now that you're here, really quick, Vic Vega made a point. You know, Tracy Morgan gained 40 pounds while taking a Zympic. Which further backs up my theory that all these drugs that you guys are taking to lose weight, your body will find a way to get used to it like any drug. Like any drug, your body starts gaining a resistance for shit that's not supposed to be in the body. Cocaine, crack, Tylenol, Advil, you name it, it works the same way. Tracy Morgan was on a Zympic and literally told the person that was doing the interview, I out ate Ozempic, which is the funniest thing anybody could say. First of all, I wish I could hear Tracy say that.
I wonder if he did that on purpose.
No, you can't. I don't know if you do that on purpose, but all I know is that the shit wasn't working and he gained 40 pounds on it. And once you come off that shit, you're going to gain all that shit back, which again, there is only one formula and Mel Kwan will tell you. There's only one way to lose weight. You got to burn more calories than you put into your body. End of story. That's it.
I mean, but all smoke of those crack. Pills are nothing but appetite suppressive. That's
smoke crack.
Right. So, smoke like crack. You said,
you'd be skinny. Like you deemed it.
Smoke crack. Don't hate, man.
You'd be Slim Jim.
Here's another story. You know what? Let's go to an 80s track. I want to go.
No, whoa. Because you wait a minute. We didn't even finish about the officer.
My bad.
Diet pills and how fat.
What'd you say there, fragile man? I didn't hear.
I ain't got nothing to do with that fat boy.
I know that. Okay. It's okay, fragile man. I was talking to Keenan Cole.
Big team. Bigger team.
Big Ting Guan.
Yeah, big things are Guan for you, honey.
Keenan, I'm not being negative. I'm just merely telling you that you're putting a drug in your body that you don't know how your body will react to. You eventually will gain a resistance to it, my friend. If you want to lose weight,
are you supposed to be on the drug for long-term purposes, or is it a short amount of time to just kind of get the ball rolling with the weight loss journey?
I'm telling you, as soon as you stop that shit, he'll gain that shit back. Like,
sit your fat ass down somewhere, Keenan. Yeah. Anyway, this morning I woke up to the story about the officer.
Why are you such a Negatron, my friend?
Yeah, what's wrong with you today?
I am for now. He said, "Go sit they don't your stop. Fat. You want to keep poking the door now?
He does it.
I'm aggressive. All right, I'm aggressive. Okay." Yeah. Word.
Okay.
But the officer that got killed, he was from Long Island, and which was crazy because I woke up to that story this morning on the news. And
how come you never bring any articles with you to the show?
Well, I don't need to.
Okay.
That's what that's the answer you need. I don't need to, sir. You're going to
kid members only let them out once a day.
I have it up here.
The fuck you want me to do?
Yeah. But homie. Rest in peace, man. That was a bad situation. And he's from Long Island. I saw his family, his moms and pops on the news and shit. He had a wife. He had two young kids, man. That's horrible. But it's
fucked up.
You know, like, he don't have no bad reputation. He was much loved in this town. You know what I'm saying? Much loved. So, but this the thing. They already about to start all this open frisks and all that shit.
Good.
Stopping this shit.
Good.
So it's like the streets is making it worse because homie was a good cop.
He wasn't a bad cop.
He was on the force for 3 years.
No citations,
nothing. He was a good cop. I don't know. I don't know his name offhand. That's
good cops shouldn't have to do traffic infractions. That's what I say.
But he was just doing his job, man. You're not supposed to park at the bus stop. It's certain feet and room you got to give the bus to enter and leave from
regular shit.
Regular shit. You got to move your car.
Yeah.
And he didn't know. And then the shooter shot him under the vest. Like nobody's paying attention. He hit him underneath the vest.
That's crazy.
That was smart.
That was a lucky shot.
He was aiming too, because if you aim, he had to be really like if you're a shooter, you had to really be aiming down. Because once that shit kicked, it ain't gonna that shit gonna bounce up.
But then you got to look at the angle where old boy was. If he came right to his window, then his stomach and chest
right there.
Yeah, so as soon as he clears that little ledge for the window where the window go in and bust, it's right there. So that was just a
vest. You're right. Perfect Mr. J, the vest only go down to your belly button.
You so fucking coffee?
Say that
you
again.
You over there with the pen? You need some coffee?
No. I want to let everybody
talk.
He's
at the door. He's like,
No, right. Like, so instead of talking, I can do the pen. I'm like, Anyway, 80s Wednesday. Listen, Cliff made a selection. Wait a minute.
Let's go, Cliff.
Cliff made a selection. You know, sometimes I'll be downloading sounds and it don't be coming through. Fuck, I don't think JP has a song. Cliff made a selection. Bats made a selection. Vic made a selection. Eugene made a selection. Brooks's selection was the Puffy song.
Puff Daddy and the Family.
Eugene Cougin made a selection. And let's get right into it. I'm going to start off with Vic Vega because nothing says 80s.
Why like always Vic Vega?
Oh,
what is your problem?
His fucking song for when I leave, bro.
What?
Save his song for when I leave in 10 minutes.
I'm playing the song so you can leave quicker.
Oh, okay. Oh, even better. Thank you, sir. Even better.
Nothing says the 80s like Revenge of the Nerds.
Oh, God.
Man. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Mel Quan is hating so hard.
Remember Lamar?
It was Wormser. Wasn't that Wormser planet?
Yeah,
it was
Wormser. And the cocky came in every time.
Clap
please everybody, and everybody clap your hand. We lambda, 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 and Omega Moon. And we've come on stage tonight to do a show.
The Mario cousin.
We got a rockin' rhythm and a high-tech sound that'll make you move your body down to the ground. We got Poindexter on the violin, and Lewis and Gilbert will be joining in. We got Booger Presley on the main guitar, and a rap by little old me, Lamar. We got Tekashi beating on his gong. The boys and the moves are clapping along. And just when you thought you seen it all, along comes a lambda 4 foot tall. So won't you come on out here on the floor, so we can work our bodies like never before.
This is some silly shit. Huh. Revenge of the Nerds.
This is when Big Vegas in the mirror.
Big Vegas chose this?
Yeah.
Big Vegas chose this?
Yeah, he waits for Bat to leave the crib. He in the mirror.
Oh, shit.
Come on, man.
Fucking shit.
Keenan, you
look at that. The
synthesizers, man.
Keenan, you look at that.
And Lamar dancing.
Yeah.
Vic has some interesting, really cool choices, man. No, and I forgot about that. I fucking love that little riff, man. Melquan, you seem not to be happy with Vic Vegas' choice.
Me in the bathroom with some underoos on, bats ain't at the queer.
That was a pause song.
Yeah, that was a pause song.
That was a pause. No under way. Right, pause hold on. Hold on. If that was a pause song,
I'm not gay.
I gotta do that for Vic. Come on, if you guys just say that's a pause song.
Word,
D Holla. That's what I said when I got the choices last night. I said that. Devious, bloody Victor Vega always picks the fucking weirdest songs. But when I fucking heard it, I was like, holy shit.
Who would have thought to play that shit, though? That was a classic.
Dude, I'm telling you right now.
You gotta get the video.
All right, let's do another Long Island story while Melquan is here. This is the story of the high school coach that raped a player and then was let out on bail and then walked off a train track in front of an LIRR and took his life. I wanna commend him for taking his life.
Wow.
Yeah,
what the hell, buddy?
Yep, he saved that the taxpayers. Yeah. He saved the taxpayers' money.
You can't salute that, man. He made people late for coming home from work.
Well, sometimes you got to be late for work.
There's street
justice being served, sir. Universal justice was being served that morning. Cousin Eugene.
He
22-year-old Jason Mazur.
Another story that Melquan has failed to bring to the show.
Who was a high school volleyball coach and a club volleyball coach is now facing felony rape charges accused of having sexual intercourse and oral sex with a 15-year-old player. According to court documents, the alleged incidents took place in Mazur's 2014 Jeep Cherokee in Albertson on February 7th and March 7th, while Mazur was working as a part-time coach at Sacred Heart Academy, an all-girls Catholic high school in Hempstead.
Now, the school did issue a statement to the community today saying that Mazur is no longer employed here and that the school took immediate steps to ensure he had no access to school property or school activities.
Quote, when Sacred Heart learned of the situation involving Jason Mazur, Sacred Heart Academy notified the appropriate authorities and offered all available resources to the family. Mazur also coached for B&B Volleyball based in Albertson. According to a statement from the club's director, Mazur was immediately terminated and the incident was reported to the club's overseeing agencies as required. Quote, recently a report was received of an inappropriate sexual relationship between an adult who coached for B&B Volleyball and one of our players. This report was the first notice B&B Volleyball received about the relationship, and of course we were concerned for the well-being of our player and her family first and foremost. Prosecutors said in court that Mazur is facing up to 4 years behind bars if he's convicted of the top charge. He is now out on bail,
a judge did issue a stay-away order.
We're not in a position to make a comment today. Obviously, the bail set was very high. We're going to get Jason out, and we'll deal with the case going forward.
The Manhasset school superintendent confirmed that Mazur also coached boys varsity volleyball there for one season in 2022, but that there were no complaints against him during that time.
Mrs. Mazur, do you want to say anything?
Mazur lives in Syosset with his parents, who were in court today but didn't answer questions. He's due back in court next month. In Hempstead, I'm Shari Einhorn for Newsday TV.
Okay, so I just showed you that video. So this was everything that happened before he could kill himself. Okay? So either he thought he couldn't do the 4 years, the shame, the guilt, whatever.
Man, he ain't going to be somebody's bitch.
Was it consensual?
That was his fear. Yeah, that's what I was trying to figure out.
Was it consensual?
Because he looked kind of young.
I don't know.
He's 22.
She was 15.
Yeah.
So I know that.
Well, even if it was consensual, I thought he was younger than 22. Even if it was consensual,
did he force himself?
Well, even if it was consensual, then it's statutory rape, isn't it?
Yeah, statutory.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. Okay. So then it does. It's rape. It's either way. It's rape.
He lured her into his Jeep.
Mm. She could have backed it up and lured him.
He said, "Back seat of my Jeep, let's swing an episode." That's what he said.
Yeah. Well, and he went straight to hell, and he's covered on that
train.
Crazy, man. You really think that he was so afraid of going to jail that he took his own life? It was a fear.
Absolutely. You don't think it was shame that led him to take his life?
No, he cared
less. That was some jail shit.
It was some jail shit, huh? He was like, Jesus Christ. Yeah, but
he knew he was going to be wearing Kool-Aid lipstick. He knew this.
Oh, Jesus, Kool-Aid.
You ain't know that, Brooks?
No, I didn't.
Yeah,
Kool-Aid lipstick.
You a punk in jail, they get the Kool-Aid and you put that around your lips and that's what you wear.
And then the pressure, the media, the pressure from all that shit probably was in his head and shit. Man, that's sad, man.
You know, then, you front line when you go to jail. Your case on the news.
Hey, you know what? What's also sad, Blue Label, that this young teenager has to live with this shit for the rest of their lives too.
Yeah, so
that is also sad, and I agree with you that it hurts. Yeah.
Her family, everything.
B. Hollis said, "That's it. He knew he was going to be someone's bitch in jail, and he took his life. That's fucking crazy."
So I talked to my daughter, man. I'd be like, "Man, listen, any signs of
because girls that age do be trying to be too grown and shit. They be fucking with older dudes and shit,
right?"
So that's why I mentioned that. That's why I asked, was it consensual?
So, Brooks, you're saying that the female may have enticed him.
That's what I was asking. Right. But it doesn't matter.
You're a fucking teacher, for crying out loud.
But see, here's the thing, Rich.
You have to show restraint.
They may have been involved, and the parents find out, reported. Now, you know what I'm saying? Whether she wants to or not, the parents reported she's a minor, period.
Yeah.
So even if it was consensual, the parents reported.
Like some Pretty Little Liar shit.
Exactly. He ain't got that Kelly money to throw him like
that. I used to love that show.
Pretty Little Liar shit.
He used to love that show.
It was some Pretty Little Liar.
Yo, that show was intriguing. I love that shit.
Yeah, that's crazy, though.
You know, we have
a sad story, though, man. That's fucked up.
We have a problem in New York City with the train system.
I used to like the lesbian,
aside from the crime in the train stations, we have a problem of people pushing people over on purpose.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I don't know why they're doing that shit here. They said that's like some gang initiation or some dumb shit.
It could be. You know, I, for one, I don't understand people that wait for the train. Why aren't you playing the stairs? Like, I would not be. There's no way. Like, there's no way I would let anybody stand behind me waiting for the train. Blue Label, is this not? Am I not right? Am I not bugging my head? Like, why would you not be playing?
Like, I do that too.
I'm going to be standing on the second stair, leaning against the handrail, waiting for the train, looking at my phone. This way, if somebody pushes me, you're just going to push me down two stairs. I'm not going to go falling over to the train, right?
Yeah.
You're not even going to move, bro.
Well, that's true. Fragile man, I am hard to move. Unlike yourself, where you would have to tie rope to the staircase.
You're like 4 cents.
This way, nobody can push you over.
You ain't even going to move. If he can't breathe.
4 cents. Let me give you an applause for that.
Well, I heard that shit.
I did hear that shit, man. I heard that. It's part of an initiation with young motherfuckers, some silly shit they doing. Now they killing people. They trying to push people. Yeah, that's crazy.
So the guy that did it is completely fucking insane. He was smiling on the perp walk, no care whatsoever.
I'll be on the trains on the 15th.
Calculated. We know you take the train, sir. We know you take the train.
I'll be on demon time, not doing nothing.
You don't have a vehicle.
I grew up in it. You don't either, bro.
You don't have a vehicle, fragile man.
Having your mom's car. Okay, let's go.
Don't you be talking about my mama.
Okay. That's not your car, bro. You drive your mama's car.
You keep my mama out of this.
I'd rather pay.
All right. Here's the video with the crazy man. This fucking guy. Let me tell you something. If I was a mayor, if I was running the Hey, peace, Melquan. Thank you. Salute to Melquan for the show today.
Everybody have a bad day. Flip over your own.
Bye.
Okay.
Not an angry man's car.
I hope his bus can't come.
Fragile man was not happy today.
Angry man. Bitter man.
That was funny, though. He said, That was hilarious. He said, I weighed 400 pounds and nobody could move me on the train. I thought that was funny. It's so funny. I love Melquan. All right. Anyway, here is the video of this guy that pushed. This person, I'll tell you his name right now if you give me 1 second. Oh no, it'll be in the video.
Dominican blowout is fire.
I'm not.
Why'd you kill that guy?
Listen. Dímelo. Oh, that's when I'm done. Dígame. Okay, let's go.
24.
All right, Carlton McPherson, that's his name.
Why'd you kill that guy? Why'd you kill the strap hanger? Why'd you kill him?
Something mental is wrong with him.
I don't know how mentally it is if he waited and calculated the train coming and waited for the perfect moment to build up his momentum and push the person over. Like, he waited. He calculated that shit. He's like the pusher.
Listen, he's on wet.
It was a Stephen King character. This guy used to get off on pushing people onto things or pushing things onto people.
He's
a bunch of folk out here like that, unfortunately, man.
Yeah, he definitely on wet because
mentally ill motherfuckers is taking anything.
Yeah, I'm looking at his outfit and it's not a homeless outfit. You understand what I'm saying? He got the Nike slides on.
I was just like, he got Nike slides on.
Yeah, I saw the post. Yeah, I saw the slides on.
He's definitely on some wet, you know what I'm saying? And he's out his damn mind. He is.
Yeah,
if I was 5'4", 470 bats, I'd be a ball. I'd be round. I'd be a round ball.
Eugene, did you see him? He looks sick.
Unless they beat him up. That PCP be having him like skitzing out his damn mind. That's that wet, boy.
80s Wednesday, we'll be right back. We're going to play one more song and then come right back.
Don't stand.
Rock on. Ignite my song. Bring my posse along to the party, cause danger zone. From the heart is in effect. So I say, buddy, study. Think and learn. Dig the move we made. Stunning those that just can't behave. Discipline. Here's a hint. It's cool from the damn hand too. Tough. All up in you with the formula coming from me, cause no one told ya of a logo of Zeria saying this ain't no joke, Jimmy. I ain't playing, I'm hardcore, straight up raw. I'm the overlord, ice door clocking. But no, as if you didn't know, fronting on the scene when it's time to go. Asking for a number from any member of the tough crew band. Remember, jacking on my tip, over tipping my shoulder. I've been a soldier, a team roller, smashing those who stand in my path. Counting them down like math. And mapping, rapping them down for my part of town.
Girl.
I know who this is. You can't think who it is. That's cool.
Yes, we're back. Another verse of rap, another tune, a bar, a star. Yo, the pack is filling, chilling, billing, willing. So shock, clap, and rock to the point of no return, or to the point of madness and burn. Starters, I call suckers, or a new jack. In case you never knew that, the crew is back. Check out the scenery, Jim. You're not the future, you're history. You try to compete and bust my groove, but when it came to battle, where the fuck were you? Hardcore, on wax, and I'll sell it. That's how we roll, so that's how I tell it. Call it dope, call it what you want, but the fact remains we're getting paid up front. Tax free, money in my pocket, trim from the ladies, cause I know they jack it. Superior, on the mic when needed. Surprise call, cycle's completed. Facts I gather, position is stronger. Remain alert just a little bit longer, as I pound you down with the funky sound from my part of town.
Yeah. Damn.
Every was a banger though.
Spending dough, wasting time on a so-called rhyme, a so-called rapper with a so-called beat. All that shit is weak. Keep my stand, yo, tell me, man. I can't understand this dude and what we're coming to. What is wrong with you? What you trying to do? Yo, once again, the judge with the grudge, the jury with fury to stomp on your mug. Yes, of course, a rap course you take. Make no mistake, I called you a fake. BS walking, money is talking. I'll retaliate, but wait. For the beat to come back in, stop slacking off, cause I'm packing gyms, clubs, dams, name them all. We bring down the wall. Down with my boys, cause I gotta be down for my part of town.
Yeah.
Up to the danger zone posse from the north side, you know what I'm saying? She walked me. Don't damn pop.
Hold up. Sit a dookie, don't shout out to all the fly skiage. My mom, Bobby, love for the knowledge. The warlock squad in action. My man, Adam Levy, at the top of the heat. To the godfather, Mitch, got things all hemmed up. A-Tech in effect. West Oakland, G-Town, my part of town. 3-2 cross the bridge, you know what I mean? Yeah, I want to say what's up to my South Philly danger zone posse. A special hello to my mom, 28th Street, Tasker. 24th Street, Mike C, my brother Tron, my sister Evie's Hoagie House, the Tassin
88,
Mighty G, yeah, boy.
They're talking they shit, man. At the end, they're talking they shit.
Yeah, you gotta get that a shout dope. Out to the city, you know what I mean?
Who is that again? Who?
Tough? No, Tough. T-U-F-F. Tough Crew.
Tough Crew.
Oh, Tough Crew.
No, not Tough. Yeah. Tough. Tough.
Yeah, Tough.
Oh, okay. I think you said Tough.
That was tight. That was tight.
Yeah. Okay, so that was Eugene's choice, and that was Bats's choice. Two great 80s selections.
That was dope.
Okay. Yep. Brooks, what did you feel about Bats's song really quick? Did you
It was a little too 80s for me.
Too 80s?
Yeah. I'm a little younger. So okay. In the 80s, you know.
All right, anyway.
I love Bats though.
I wasn't asking you.
It reminded me of like John Hughes.
I was
movies,
asking you
like,
what you thought of her song.
That was like my days. They remind me of those days.
You know what it is? I know all the songs, but I don't know the names. Yeah. So when Bat sent me the choice, I said, what the fuck is this orchestra? Then I played the song and I said,
Holy I know that.
Shit.
It just put you in the mind of like John Hughes movie.
Like us. I fucking love that
I
shit.
I feel
love
like
that
watching song. 16 Candles or something.
Yeah.
It puts you in that 89.
Anyway, 2 days ago, Monday, early Tuesday morning, in Baltimore, fucking container ship sends out a mayday and said, we have lost power to the ship. Okay.
Some sad shit.
For some reason, they couldn't stop the ship and they couldn't steer the ship, and the fucking ship went into a bridge, and this bridge buckled like it was made out of toothpicks. Like it's
exactly
out of a fucking movie. It's crazy, right? Physics, ladies and gentlemen.
That's the sad part, how hard it buckled.
Look at this like, shit. Look at this shit.
Yeah.
It folded like a cheap shirt.
Yeah, like a cheap suit. Yeah, look at that. Could you imagine just driving to work?
The lawsuit that's about to come out of this shit.
It folded like Mel Kwan's application for credit to get a car.
But you know one good thing? Did you see that 18-wheeler that had just cleared the bridge on the land side before it went down?
No. I thought I thought the mayday that they sent out was why traffic stopped across the bridge.
Well, so I saw one video where, and they broke it down like screen by screen or frame by frame or whatever. It's like the shipping truck lost electricity. Then like a couple seconds later, it came back on. Then it lost it again, but they couldn't steer it. They couldn't get control of it. Yeah. And then it lost power again. And then that's when it hit a certain exact section of the bridge where it just was the weakest point and just collapsed it all. Had it went, let's just say, a couple feet to the right or a couple feet to the left of the point of impact, only that section would have broken. But the bridge, it just looked like
it was at a crucial point, right?
Yeah, it hit it right in one of the support beams. And it just took out one. It just took out that support beam. And it was like one of the big ones, too. So it provided major support.
That's funny.
That's crazy, man. Like,
bodies.
I couldn't imagine. I couldn't fucking imagine.
The ship that hit the Baltimore Bridge is a 948-foot container ship called the Dolly. The Dolly was traveling from Baltimore to Sri Lanka when it crashed into the Francis Scott Key Bridge, causing a portion of the bridge to collapse into the Patapsco River. The ship had issued a Mayday warning before the collision, which helped reduce traffic on the bridge. The National Transportation Safety Board has announced that it will investigate the incident. The Coast Guard will come in, because I was talking to a guy on my block who's a Marine, and he was like, the Coast Guard's going to come in, drug test everybody on the ship, first of all. They're going to find
out.
They pulled
them all first thing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
They do that with any accident, like public transportation, any of that shit. First thing they do is somebody on the scene, grab your ass off. Let's go.
Shit like that make me mad, because that could have been avoided, man.
Could have been avoided. Yeah. So, absolutely.
Also, can I just add something to, as of 11 minutes ago, a report came out on MSNBC that says that they're going to suspend all active search and rescue efforts. The Coast Guard is not going away. None of the partners or any affiliate vendors are going away. It's just the water is too cold, and the six people who have believed to be a part of the construction crew repairing potholes on the bridge are now assumed dead.
Yep. That's the last one.
I saw cars and shit going down with that, man.
Well,
A bunch of cars that were still on there went down too.
Well, now, were those people evacuated or was it people in those cars? Because they looked like they was moving too. It should be crazy.
I think they pulled a lot of the cars out with the people in them and stuff like that. Like, they're not announcing how many total dead, but those are the ones that's just unaccounted for, the dudes on there that was fixing the potholes.
Well, here's the question I want to ask about the people fixing the potholes on the fucking bridge. They didn't have no fucking radios when the Mayday went out.
Well, here's the thing, though.
They had their AirPods on, listening to, whatever.
You know, when you're on your job, be on your job. There's a radio is there to communicate with you, to tell you there's a fucking ship out of control.
Hold on, Rich.
But the bridge, that could have been way a couple miles down.
Hold on. Not only that, look at it like this, Rich. With most shit like that, they contract that out. So that was probably a private company.
So they had a radio between themselves, so many levels.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's the first thing I said. Where the fuck are their radios, man?
But I did see one report. It was this dude that said, shout out to the people he seen who was jumping out their cars, stopping traffic from going after the bridge fell. Because he said people was out there hard ass and didn't even know the bridge.
Yeah, because they're not thinking the fucking bridge collapsed in the middle and shit and another half standing up.
Exactly,
can you imagine cars just fucking jetting to work, flying over? Oh my God.
Yo.
Fucking crazy.
But can you
imagine that shit make me mad, man? I know it was more people on that fucking bridge than they're trying to say.
Shit.
Yeah, I'm about to say you froze up. But can you imagine the dude that called up to his job person, like, listen, I can't come into work, the bridge collapsed?
Yeah, they're like, come on, dude.
Hold on, can I
just add something? Actually, Eugene is actually 100% correct. Construction workers were contracted out with the state through a transportation agency. So they might have not had communication.
See what an asset Brooks and Kujin Eugene is to this channel. Can you, see Ideal Quan on a daily basis? You know what I'm saying? Like, back today's back. Like my dream. I dream of shows like today. Are you kidding? This is Podcaster Mega Millions jackpot for me right here. To have a female on the show as intelligent as Brooks, Kujin Eugene, Blue Label, who's never here, just totally ruined Melquan's day. I sent Vic Vega a fucking, an invite to come to the show. Mind you, he has a day off today. Did not want to come share his share the show time with us. But at least you would have came on to make Melquan upset. I'm surprised you did.
My sleep was too good.
He's enjoying the plant-based.
Oh, breakfast. He could be. Well, you know what? He's probably enjoying a romantic morning with his lovely girlfriend. So
probably, breakfast in bed and shit, grapes.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you.
No, Vic do.
Yeah.
And it also says the pilot of the ship did everything that he could have done. There are no criminal at this point, no criminal towards him.
Investigations.
You can't blame him because
who, the captain?
You can't blame him.
Can't blame him. They send out the Mayday, but they're gonna drug test everybody anyway. They got
absolutely.
You just brought down a fucking bridge.
He said he did all appropriate steps necessary to try to save it.
Exactly. And boats are just like planes. Like they're all.
You better hope so.
Once the electronics go, like they even set on course probably electronically. But once the electronics go, that thing's going to start drifting where it's going to drift to.
Somebody got to go. Somebody got to take the hit for this. You took out a whole fucking bridge and hurt all those people.
Absolutely. And to add more fuel to the fire, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Guatemala is now in the mix because a statement Tuesday said that two of the missing workers are of Guatemalan origin.
Wow.
And one of them is 26. Is 26, the other one is 35. So they are checking to see their status and who hired them and if they were legal.
Mm-hmm.
Two of them are from Mexican descent.
I don't feel comfortable looking at
Vic on the Mexicans.
Goodbye, Vic.
Oh God, Vic Vega, why you come? I'm looking at the archive. He come over here half naked.
Fuck, you want me to do?
It's got a t-shirt on.
Hey, everybody, look at everybody, look at what a chest is not supposed to look like. There you go. Vic Vega looked like he dropped his chest on the floor this morning. Hey, pick up your chest when you're gonna come into the camera with your little chest. Look at all like you be lifting weights. Anyway,
you know,
Jesus,
what?
that was disturbing.
They're gonna blame that on the safety of the boat. They're gonna pull the maintenance records to see the boat wasn't maintained correctly and start to blame it on the company.
Full cavity search on this. Full cavity search.
How you gonna come to the camera and your chest is on the floor? Only question I gotta ask. All right.
But they lining them Mexicans up though. You see that with Brooks said they lining them Mexicans up to take the blame.
Yeah.
Oh, China. That's the conspiracy theory is China.
To take the blame for what?
The bridge shit.
Oh, yeah. No, it's fucking American engineering and not giving a fucking and checking the structural integrity of the bridge you built over time. That's what it is. It's a lack of fucking people doing their job. Okay, if you go on some of these bridges, I'd look at the rust at some of these bolts and I'm like, good God, man, Bolts made in 1797. Still shit ain't been changed, man.
Cheap motherfuckers, man.
Yeah, yeah. Any way to save a fucking dollar. Anyway, we got some more video of the Puffy raid. Let's look at this.
Oh, yeah, let's get into this.
Done.
What a great show today was. I think the only thing that ruined today's show was Vic Vega's chest. Totally ruined the show.
Oh my God, I can't.
I made a mistake. Remind me never to send him a link again. Fucking guy comes on.
We talk shit about Vic. He popped up like, what?
We should have popped up when Melquan was on the air. That was the whole right reason. With Blue Label and Vic Vega on the show, Melquan would have been very unhappy. It would have got him off the show.
Puffy's attorney made a statement. Did you guys see that? Let me see if I can pull that up.
I know. What's his name made a statement. The lawyer that represents the female that got the first check from the first lawsuit, his ex-girlfriend.
Cassie's lawyer.
Yeah. Thank you, Cassie's lawyer.
Puff lawyer said they was over aggressive and
yes,
army,
military-like.
Yeah, military-like presence, and you know, nobody was arrested. Man, listen,
it kind of was military presence.
You think R. Kelly sitting in jail get him?
You would have thought it was sex slaves in the basement.
Go ahead, Brooks. Go ahead.
So Aaron Dyer, which is the attorney for Sean Puff Daddy Combs, said yesterday was a gross overuse of military level force as search warrants were executed at Mr. Combs's residences. There is no excuse for the excessive show of force and hostility exhibited by authorities or the way his children and employees were treated. Combs was never detained, but spoke to and cooperated with the attorneys. And none of the rapper's family members were arrested. This unprecedented ambush, paired with an advance coordinated media presence, led to a premature rush of judgment of Mr. Combs and is nothing more than a witch hunt based on meritless accusations made in civil lawsuits. So basically, the feds alerted the media so that they could be present with the drones, with the cameras, with the paparazzis and everything like that. So they can show them with this excessive force coming in his house, because there's no way we would have known and or seen his kids being arrested. Now, I saw the pictures of both his sons in handcuffs. I think it was Christian. And
they were at the house.
Yes, they were at the house. The one that looks just like him, Christian, and then
Justin.
Yeah, Justin and Christian were locked up. Were handcuffed. I'm pretty sure because they were just in the house. They probably were like, "Hey, this is my dad's house
for the moment." Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Get out. Da, da, da. Bro,
but wait a minute, Brooks? Puffy was warned, right? They were coming. That's why he was out, right?
He was out. So why didn't he tell his kids to leave?
That's hearsay. Okay,
it didn't have nothing to do with them. He knew they couldn't be arrested. It had nothing to do with him.
They would, but Brooks just said Justin and King was let out in cuffs.
Yes, anytime a raid go down, everybody getting fucking.
I got you. Because you were at the scene. I got you.
That was just for detainment purposes. So you can't run or grab nothing.
That was for picture purposes to make them look big. You're right.
But
I got you.
Hey, Brooks, did you see the one news report where the lady said she rode? The news reporter said we rode in with the convoy of 40 or something cars. She set up before they even set up the tape. You got to look it up. Literally said, yeah, we rode in with the convoy. So they had camera crew with them. Like they wanted
ready. So, and also, as you guys see down there, yes, he sold off all his shares for Revolt and he no longer has any control or any dealings with Revolt TV.
Now they sent anonymous
lawyer money
to an anonymous seller.
And not
they sold it to his mom.
An anonymous black owner or a black
purchaser. Yeah, black purchaser. Yeah. If it's anonymous,
how do you know it's a black person?
He sold it to his mom for like $100 or something that he can clear the taxes on.
Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely. With money that never changed.
It's like diabolical movements, bro, to protect your fortune. I don't blame you.
Yeah, but I was just about to say, that's what you do.
You on video, they had audio and video on you fucking doing some foul shit. It's time for you to pay the price, buddy. It's time for you to pay your dues to the universal law of karma. Because they don't care how much money you got. If they got you, they got you, dude. That's it.
If he got it, if he get out of this shit, boy.
If he gets out of this shit, he's no magic. He's the prince of darkness.
He's not getting out of it. I don't think he's
officially the prince of darkness if he gets away with
it. Ooh, he's a bad boy for real. You get out of this motherfucker, boy.
But he did sell all his shares. I'm sorry, Eugene.
He's not getting out of this.
You just shut it down.
Listen, here's my thing. I'm telling you, the feds raided Harvey. Where is he at? The feds raided Bill. Where is he at? The feds raided Jared. Where is he at?
Done.
They're not playing. When the feds step in, like I said, they don't just come for a rumor. They got enough to show a judge to say, yeah, go in there and see what else you can get.
Irv Gotti and them got away with some shit. You never know.
Yeah, but it was a different time. Yeah, Gotti was a different time.
Irv, they was after drug money and shit like that with Irv. They wasn't after no females with Irv. If they was after females, he would have got caught. You know what I'm saying? But they shut down Irv cash stream, so they still won.
You know what? I don't know if this is even true. I was just scrolling through videos on YouTube. I did not even watch the video. I just saw the video, and it said that Suge Knight said that the feds came in to destroy evidence that could be used against powerful people. I'm just going to put that out there as
I did see that. Actually, I did.
Three
I did
as see an extreme, really like JPS type of shit. You know what I mean? Like
that really, already planted some shit in there. That's already planted
really
some
shit believing, in there. Him.
No, 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 no. I'm just saying it would be like a JPS type of conspiracy. I'm just putting it out there.
Yeah, but he did say that. Yeah, I did see that he said that.
Yeah,
you know, crazy.
Let's talk. What do we got? Let's play. I'm gonna play JPS's choice for today since JPS just brought up the fact about Revolt TV. Thank you, JPS, because I was gonna forget to bring that up, and we'll be right back.
That's in your face, showing up, shrugged your face, just like you got sprayed by a can of mace. You see, your speaker is moving, everybody is grooving. My song moves along as it starts improving. The highs will get no higher, the bass will go no lower, cause everlasting bass showing up moves a flower. Some people can't take it, they try to plead the case, but you can't get enough of everlasting bass.
I can picture JPS riding to this shit too.
As fast as Carl, he's black, not Jewish, and when he's on stage, he can. And I'm good to. Yes, Rodney O, leader of the show, make the lady say, king of my castle, causing much pain. You dumb shrimp wimps, it's you I tame. So to the R, to the O, to the D, N, E, Y. Now what's that spell, Rodney? That's right.
Records, I can see JPS. And Jada Pinkett with Jerry Curls riding to this shit.
Me and Joe on the go, moving fast, not slow. Sporting feelers and Adidas and summer Kangos. We ride on 747s, not DC-10s. We'll take a 3-day vacation, then we'll do it again. Check in the hotel the day of the show. No time to play around because we got to go. You see, we're on a flight to rock the mic in Miami, Florida, where they film The Vice.
Rodney Ono was the shit, though.
JPS picked the winner.
Rodney Ono. Yeah, you got a joint.
That's the old school jump off, for real. Definitely shot me right around.
Was this the era he was hanging with Jada, though?
That, I don't know if this is the Jada era, but I know this is some dope shit.
Nah, I don't be bullshitting, though. JPS don't be lying, though. That bitch Jada been every motherfucking where, man. He probably was, hey, you know what I'm saying?
I believe him.
He been everywhere, man.
I believe him. I believe the JPS. Yeah, JPS story. It's Mel Kwan that just did not believe him.
I'm ahead to start. I joke around.
I joke around with him.
JPS, great pick.
Yeah, that was a banger back then.
Here's an interesting video I'm going to show you. The governor of Florida, Governor DeSantis, who Clark hates to a passion. And I really don't like politicians in general. But he did something that I absolutely agree with. And I don't have children. But if I did, I would be like, this is like the guy. What this guy did was, he said in Florida, it is illegal for a child under the age of 13 to have a social media account. And 14. And I, for one, say bravo. Word is wrong. Word is wrong.
Good morning. Thank you. Thanks so much. Now, with things like social media and all this, you know, you can have a kid in the house, safe seemingly, and then you have predators that can get right in there, into your own home. You could be doing everything right, but they know how to get and manipulate these different platforms. And so it's created huge problems.
There's him signing the bill. If Mel Kwan was here, he would say there's some attractive white women up there, but Mel Kwan's not here. Blue Label may be thinking it, but who am I to say?
I'm looking.
Okay, anyway, kids under the age of 14 are not allowed to have a social media account. And I say, you know what? It's a start and it's brilliant. Yeah. And for parents that have to work all day and at the mercy of what goes on TikTok and the gram and social media, and they just don't have the time. Yeah, you should listen. You shouldn't even have a phone, is what I say.
That's a whole different story, but yeah.
Should not even
back in the day it used to be like that, but
you know how nowadays some kids they need a phone.
Well, that's what I'm saying. We gave them the excuse to need one to keep up with them.
We didn't need a phone when we were kids. Why do kids say they don't need a phone?
Well, technology changed. You want to know what the fuck your kids is doing, so you call them. Right. You know what I'm saying? They can call you.
You're right.
This is the thing, too. You can get your kid a phone that don't have all that internet access and all that. They're going to get clowned so bad in school, they might become a school shooter. But they're going to get clowned. So they, you know what I mean?
Yeah, they're going to get clowned for that shit.
Might become a school shooter. You buy them that phone. So they got to get them
a track phone.
Can I tell you something? I drive through Brooklyn almost every other day, and I go to the Hasidic Jew section. No child in the Hasidic Jew cult, it's a cult, that's what I call it, is allowed to have a phone that goes onto the internet. All their phones are old school analog flip-flops.
You know why? Because they get them for free. They get the free Obama phones for free.
But they don't care about the internet. See, their kids do not get on the internet. And there's a reason for that, because they want to keep their kids brainwashed in their own fucking cult. They don't need their kids going out and learning that they have a choice and there's yeah. things outside
in
of
our this day getting on the bottom. Internet when we were growing up was like a yeah. privilege. Like
yes.
Yeah, you can get on for an hour. You know.
An hour, right. Yeah, because it used to take up the phone line.
Yes.
You'd have to plug it into your phone line. Yeah. You pick up the phone and all you hear is that on they right, all that shit. So that's why you'd be like, yo, 30 minutes, because you'd actually hijack the phone line and then
so accessible money, now.
They put in their own
kids
phone
don't
line,
got you know it. I mean? They go fucking nuts. You see with these videos where these kids don't got phones
I wish the whole system would crash. I want to see people hey. Jump off the bridge.
Okay, no, one.
Careful what you wish for, sir.
Listen,
Mel, you hear me, Mel? Representing for us.
Plugged out the matrix and go crazy.
Listen, hey, Blue, you ever seen them videos where their parents be destroying their kids' PS5
or Xboxes? Xbox. Yeah,
kids be losing.
No, no. Would they take cameras to it?
Yo, they
no, 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 no. This fast. One guy, he took his son's games. Like the games that go in the Xbox or PS5 or something like that, mm-hmm. put it in the yard and rolled over it with his riding lawnmower.
Oh.
Almost killed himself right there. The mother's videotaping it, and the kid is freaking out. But hold on, the crazy part is he's like 24, 23 or something like that.
Yo,
he's not like 10 or anything. Oh, it's
good.
I gotta find it and
parents,
I'll send it to you.
Man. Yeah,
I think
send yeah. it. Yo, can you send me links so we can show it on Friday?
Okay, yeah, I gotta try to find
oh
it.
Oh my god,
that'll make Ruckus Day to see somebody's game get snagged.
No, yo. Parents actually taking control. God,
yeah,
he's
like,
this shit.
You need to start paying.
I want to bring back child beatings. I want to see parents be able to whip the shit out of their kids and start disciplining them again. Not abusing
happening.
Their children. Not abusing their children.
Not in public.
Public. My father beat my ass, and he preferred to do it in public so he could shame me in front of people.
I got plenty of ass whoopers in public.
Are you crazy? That's what parents love to do it the most.
You know what? I got a different take on it. Like, it wasn't done to me in public, so I wouldn't do it to my kids. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Plucked, mushed.
Yeah, we got popped.
My mother, listen, my mother came to me on 85th Street and 25th Avenue, and I couldn't see. She had something in her hand, and I couldn't see what it was. And I said, oh, shit. My mom, like, yo, here comes your mom. And said she don't look happy. What was she doing? She was untying a metal hanger.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
And as she got closer, she straightened it out. She made it nice. Fuck. And she whipped me from 85th Street to 87th Street back home. I must have had like 60 lashes on.
We've got hands of iron to untie one of those things.
Yeah. You know what they did? You know what happened? They went to my mom's. They went to my mom's house and said, "Yeah, your son's starting fires in people's backyard."
Plus, doing all that whipping your kid in public shit—that shit embarrassing, man. That should embarrass you.
Listen here, Blue.
Listen, my friends were on the floor laughing.
Man, I got my ass whooped on this.
Me too. Not in public, at home.
No,
at home.
In public, yeah, Cousine Eugene. Please share with me your worst public beating. That was my worst. That's Blue Label. That's not me. That's Blue Label interrupted him.
It's an intersection in Philadelphia called 34th and Hafford down the bottom where I'm from. I was supposed to go to the barbershop. My mom gave me $10. I didn't go to the barbershop. I went up the street to Mr. Cousins Arcade, like Samuel Jackson had in Juice.
Yeah.
I went up there and spent the money.
Got yourself what? 25 quarters.
No. I think I spent like maybe $6 in games and the rest on candy and watched a few videos. You know, my mom came home from work. See, I didn't get my hair cut. So when she told me to sit on the steps and wait for her, I was up the street. So she came up the street with a belt. And, you know, there's four corners to an intersection. She beat me on this corner, We crossed the street. She beat me on another corner.
God damn right.
She beat me on the other corner. She beat me on all four corners. All four corners? Walked me down the street, whooping my ass back to the house.
Yeah, that, you know what we call that? We call that an east, west, north, south whoop ass whooping. That's what we
got. She took me back. I did not move off the steps. She went upstairs and got $10 more and walked me down the street with the belt in hand to the barbershop.
Mm. Eugene, if you don't mind, can applaud? Can I just applaud? Can I applaud Vic Vega's mom for whipping him while he was still wet, naked, coming out? You have no idea how you have no idea how happy you made me by telling me that whipping you while you's wet.
That's fucking abuse.
Just like abuse. A Puerto Rican mother.
No, Blue Label, that's not abuse. That's a lesson learned. Because I bet you learned. That's a lesson.
That's fucking torture. Said?
How dare you smoke angel dust in my bathroom?
I got it with an extension cord once. Yeah. My pop tore my ass up and burned the seats in his caddy.
Oh, man. Yeah, I would have fucked you up, too.
It wasn't my fault though. In my defense, dude went to a bar, was in there for a minute. I'm seeing a little lighter in the back seat. You know, it lights up all bright. He got cream seats, so I see the back of it. So I'm just like, oh, okay. It leaves it. Oh, okay.
How old were you?
Probably about like maybe 6 or 7.
Oh, that's even worse. For all of those people out in ruckus land who don't understand the significance of a Cadillac in the 70s and the 80s.
Hey, my pops had an Eldorado.
That's just as good.
Emerald green Eldorado, son.
Is the creme de la creme of cars. Yeah. And Eugene thought he was slick. And he got, that work.
And here's the thing. Eugene.
I would have got away with it too. But you know, old school parents, when my dad went to back up and put his hand on that right hand thing there. And
Something on the right.
He immediately threw that shit back in park and jumped out.
What the fuck?
Brooks, if you don't mind, let's applaud Eugene's dad for being so
you know how they put that hand on there, and he put that hand behind it and turned behind it. It's like, what the? Do that big back in parking. From there on, it was, you know,
felt that sear.
It was a lesson. Felt that sear.
Never sat in that back seat the same again.
Shit.
We'll be right back. This is when Brooks used to break dance for money.
MCMI, people call me Milk. When I'm busting up a party, I feel no guilt. Gizmo's cutting up for the suckers that's down with me. The one of us, that's how I feel. To be down, you must appeal to the two. We're rated R, we're gifted, and we're going far down the road to the bank. While I'm here, I'd like to thank Mom and Dad, they knew the time. Gizmo scratching, Milk D's rhyming, Milk is chilling, Giz is chilling. What more can I say? Top villain, that's what we get. Got it good, since you understood. Would you stop scheming and looking hard? I got a great big bodyguard, so step up if you wanna get hurt. Milk D's gonna pull this skirt. I get money, money I got. Stunts call me honey. They feel real hot. That's how it is. You can ask kids. I stole your girl while you were in prison. Jail for MC assault. You was jealous. It's all your fault. Milk is chilling. Giz is chilling. What more can I say? Top billing. That's what we get. Got it good. And since you understood, would you clap your hands? Your hands, you clap. If your girl's out of place, it's your girl I slap. And if you're dumb, why I am from that do or die. The audio two, the two's audio. I got a brother and his name's Gizmo. Milk is chilling, Gizmo's chilling. What more can I?
don't care. My contributions to this jam is confusing because I am Milk D stated all the way. The super easy modest MC, okay. Yes, I'm down, down by law. I get the girlies out on the floor. G is D, down is G. Tuva at the top is where he'll be. At is us, call us on. Girls come in, you won't be bored. Milk is chilling, Gizmo's chilling. What more can I say? Top billing, that's what we get. Got it good, and since you understood, would you do a dance? Dance the two. If you can dance, it's easy to do. This dance is on and on and on. Dance until your breath is gone.
I just saw him last year.
That was my selection for today.
Classic.
Classic, yeah. Top billing.
I just saw him last year at the 50 Hip Hop reunion.
If that song doesn't remind you of summer, I don't know what does, man.
So many things.
Right. What else is going on as far as the top five stories trending in the U.S. today?
Not that it matters to me, but did you hear about that idiot Charleston White and the other idiot Gilly?
Oh, right. Keenan. Right. So I did not see the video, but I believe Charleston White made a video making fun of the fact that Gilly's son was murdered, correct?
Yeah.
You know what? Okay, listen.
He basically took on a drill rapper from Chicago talking about rest in piss, nigga, and all of this, trying to be like old Dirk and all of them. So.
Yeah, as a man, you lose a piece of your honor when you... when you make fun of
tasteless shit.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Just to get views. So you not only lose a piece of your honor, your integrity goes out the window. You know, you have a lot of good points. Charleston White does make a lot of good points, but when you do shit like that, it doesn't really matter. So you're fucking up your own image. It's obviously you just don't give a fuck. That's your attitude to get views. And
just running out of shit to do.
Yeah, you're going to run out of shit to do and say. And for the people that like that shit, you know, you got to ask yourself, you know, everybody gets their turn. You know, everybody gets their turn. Like, you can't be laughing at somebody's son being murdered, regardless of the fact of whoever's son it is and how it benefits you talking about it. You just, I can't listen to shit like that. It's just. It's a waste of time. Like, who wants to watch something like that? That's not content. You understand what I'm saying? It's just not content. And I hope Gilly doesn't reply, but I don't know. You know,
he's free to do whatever. That's some shit right there. That, it, like I say, messy. I don't want to wish nothing on nobody. It's just messy.
But see, honestly, though, speaking from Philly, though, it's enough. Are these little young boys out here in the streets that are Merc Charleston White from Philly or Jersey, if he ever show up in there on the strength of
Gilly. Just on GP,
Just to get some points with him, you know what I'm saying? Just to put their name out there. But if you know Charleston White whole background, the fact that he is as phony as he is, I can't listen to nothing he say, even if it's disrespectful. Like, I already know you're doing it for clout and fame and money. Mm-hmm. You said it yourself. So,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
Didn't Cam Newton have him on his podcast once?
And he was just sitting there.
Yeah, they just sitting there saying ignorant shit. And I was just like, you know, so it's funny in the beginning, right? It's funny.
And then you get a couple of laughs, you know.
You get a couple of laughs, but you sit through that old shit. I mean, the guy's a radical, no question. He's a radical thinker. But, you know, to go at a dead man's son is what
it's a reflection of who he is.
Yeah, he's tasteless.
If that makes any sense.
You have no class, sir. Well, you're classless.
It keeps him relevant for the temporary. See, like,
yeah, but to who? To other classless people. I'm like,
right,
who
but see, here's
this
the
guy?
Thing. Understand, Rich, he's not playing chess. Checkers, he's playing chess. Him right. Disrespecting is hoping that him and Gilly get into a boxing match where he can get a bag out of it. This is what it's going to come down to. You know what I'm saying? Everything's a show.
Gilly may whoop his ass, but I don't know.
Everything's a show with him.
That'd be a pretty good fight. They match up well.
Fuck him up. That dude is pounds.
Yeah, right. But these skinny niggas, they hit hard, these skinny ninjas.
Honestly, what I think is going to happen is somebody's going to approach
him. He always running around like a rooster every time somebody come after his ass.
I think he's going to make one of them apology videos, like when the Rolling 60s ran up on him and he made that apology video.
Oh, they got him to apologize for the shit he talked?
Man, listen, they got that.
So maybe he's not as stupid as he looks, huh?
Yeah, he made a video about, you know, I'm sorry about anything I said about the Rolling 60s. Like you can hear the fear in his voice. They caught up to him.
Speaking of chess or checkers, you ever play Chinese? You ever play Chinese checkers?
Yeah, with the little star and the marble.
Yeah, the star, and you could go from all angles and shit.
Absolutely.
You good at that?
We didn't know what we was doing, but we played
I don't even know how to play regular checkers.
You don't know how to play regular checkers? That's sad. That's easy.
My God, Brooks, you grew up with a nanny.
I grew up playing chess. My father taught me how to play nanny.
But then who cares if you don't know how to play checkers?
Little kids wasn't playing chess.
You see, in the royal family.
It's like I know course one math, but I don't know general.
We are all taught chess at the age of 8 months of age in our home.
Household. We learn chess and Madden.
I never cared to play chess.
Madden and pre-calculus at the first
grade. That's enough right there, bro. You know how to play chess and Madden.
And Madden, you're pretty sharp. You're pretty sharp.
You break out some spades. You break out some bones. And some
I don't know how to play spades. I know how to play dominoes, though.
Let me tell you something. I love playing spades, man. I am a great spades player. Dominoes, I still can't learn the logic of dominoes.
Let's throw them bones, boy.
There's a logic to that game. There's a logic to that game.
Somebody taught me. It's fun.
It is fun,
but I know how to do is match the numbers. But people are blocking people off, trying to figure out what tiles they have. I don't know how to do that. Now, spades, I can do.
Dominoes is easy, Rich, because it depends on if you're playing with big sixes, big nines, or big 12s, then it depends on the dominoes you're playing with. On how
you lost me right there. Big sixes, nines, and 12s.
Big sixes, man. You know when on the dominoes, when they got two
the matching numbers. Yes, I got you. Yeah.
Right. Those are big sixes. They have big other sixes. Multiples of them, but big sixes are the most common. You score multiples of five. So you can score in 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, or whatever.
Yeah.
And you're blocking.
I play Uno.
Yeah, you know I mean, in the process, you're blocking
Uno.
People.
Oh, Uno. Shit, that's old school.
Yeah, but see, no, effing guy, you know how you play, dominoes. So, Brooks, you know how to play dominoes and you know how to block people? You know how to play with logic and strategy or no? You just match numbers. Keep it real. You're just matching the numbers. Yeah, like.
Yeah, it'd be nice to get a game on a little trip.
All right, well, we could do that. We could do that. Brooks, I got to talk to you about what we're going to do on Sunday, okay? Okay. Saturday is pretty much figured out, but Sunday, I wanted to ask you. I had an idea, but I wanted to ask you what you thought about it. Of course. Mm-hmm. So we'll talk beyond.
Yeah, call me late. Call me a little late. Yeah, actually, I got to slide out. My mom is on her way.
All right, you know, Mama.
Hey, look, Brooks. I sent that article I was telling you about with the lady that rode in with the convoy to the chat. So look at it.
Okay. All right. Thank you. All right. I'll see you guys later.
Right. Salute.
Salute.
Peace.
Hey, Rich, I sent that to you too, Rich.
I saw it.
Yeah.
I got it. Salute to everybody that was a part of today's show. Great fucking show today, by the way. Even with Vic Vega's chest. A great fucking show today. Great music selections. I had a blast. I want everybody to have a good rest of your day. We'll be back Friday morning with another quick GTFOH Friday and some good music selected by Blue Label. So everybody have a great day. Thank you for tuning in. We got one more song by Cliff Bravo, 80s Wednesdays. I love 80s Wednesdays. I can't lie to you.